यात्रा किनु ए खपु उरोनिया आमार मो हे उजर माज खुनुवाली बात नभगरा आमार हृदय खमुकारा
Hello viewers and welcome to a brand new episode of Ek Mulaqat here on Doordarshan Northeast with me, your host Amrita. And yes, of course, we have started this brand new episode on a beautiful musical note because today we have with us two young achievers from the region who have made the region proud, and of course, they're also making waves in the national level. Well, Mandeep Mohanto and Manmeet Mohanto, first of all, thank you so much for joining us here on Doordarshan Northeast in our show Ek Mulaqat. Well, first of all, let me ask you, you have started your journey from a very young age.
Yes.
15 years, it's been, I guess, 15 years, and you started from an early childhood because you belong to a family which comprises of renowned names in music, artists and musicians and singers. So when we talk about your childhood and music, what are the first memories that come to your mind?
First memory came from the parents only, because we have been watching them performing on stages in various cultural programs. So we started learning music from them, and we used to play some minor percussions instruments with them. So those were some
started that way.
Yeah, those are very good memories.
Those were actually our first on stage experience, actually playing percussions, and you can see still I'm playing it.
Yeah. Okay, and also tell us about, was it always in your mind that you wanted to be musicians, you wanted to be singers, or was it like as kids we all grow up and we all always want that, okay, I want to become a doctor, I want to become an engineer or a teacher? These are like most common choices as kids. So
yes.
Are you chasing your dreams?
Actually, to be honest, if you want to ask actually whether we want to become musicians or not, our obsession to become a musician was always there actually, because our parents always wanted us to be good singers, or you can say the musicians of this region. So that environment is always there in our home actually. And my mother, she used to say that we want to see you in future as a good singer or a good composer, contributing something to the field of music. So that thing was always there in our mind, back of our mind actually.
So basically you all always, right from your childhood, wanted to be, wanted music as your profession, nothing else.
Yeah, during the childhood, personally I was not that was serious in any matter. That is the spontaneity still in my heart, and I don't be so much
still
with targets.
Pursuing
yeah.
it,
okay.
I'm not so much formal, so I didn't think it much about the being as a career.
Mm.
But I just loved doing music, mm. so I kept on doing it.
Mm-hmm.
Now, after a few years, when I came to realize that, okay, people are liking
the music.
Yeah, there was no such pressure actually mm-hmm. from our parents that mm-hmm. you will have to become a singer.
Mm-hmm.
But they said that we would love to see you become a good singer.
As parents, they wanted
yeah.
to
yeah,
see
yeah.
you. But mm. there was no pressure that you have to become musicians
yeah, it's
or
not
singers.
Like that.
Which is great. Also now, tell us about your band, how it formed, how the name came and the members of the band.
Well, from the very childhood, we used to perform together only
mm.
as brothers.
Mm.
And we just try to do something unique as brothers. We always perform in duo style.
Mm.
So the band name came as M Brothers.
Mm.
So we are M, Mandeep and Manmeet.
Mandeep and Manmeet.
So, so we just thought of making it as M Brothers.
Mm.
Then the last part is SH,
yeah.
the spelling is.
Mm.
Because of our another bandmate,
mm.
Shane Kemprai, we met him
okay.
in 2009
mm.
At Nogaon, our
mm.
home place.
Mm.
He came from Nagaland.
Okay.
He came for studies, but he couldn't complete study and he just go on doing music only.
Mm-hmm.
He's very a master of guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's working in Mumbai.
Okay.
So first in 2009-10 around, we both and Shane Kemprai, we
three of you.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
We planned let's do a band.
Mm-hmm.
Then we approached to other musicians,
mm-hmm.
other good musicians. We kept on searching good keyboardists,
mm-hmm.
good bass guitarists and all.
Mm-hmm.
And we started M Brothers.
That's how
yeah,
the
yeah.
band started. Okay, now it's been 15 years, I guess. So 15 years is a long time.
Yeah.
So what are your first memories of your first stage performance? Any fond memories? There must be some fond memories because first performance is always special.
First, actually, our mother gave us same kind of clothes.
Mm.
We wore uniform dresses.
Okay.
So still when we see such photographs
mm.
of our childhood, we were singing on stage, wearing the same sweaters, same color of pants. It's very memorable.
So that's very fond to you. That's very close
yeah.
to you. Okay. So we will continue our conversation, of course, but you have a guitar with you. And we would, as an audience, want to hear something nice from you. So any special original composition that you have,
definitely.
You would like to play for us?
We have just sung a song
hmm.
that was our own composition.
Okay,
that was
okay.
from our first album, Kinu
okay.
E Jatra.
Mm-hmm.
That was released in 2012.
Okay.
After the band was formed.
Mm.
So another song from that album.
Sure.
As you had said, you want a nice song.
Yeah.
And we feel it nice because this is our first composition together.
Okay, okay, sure.
And the coming song.
Sure.
He taught him a for you.
song. And our audience are definitely going to love this episode because of such musical environment that we have, you all, both of you have created in our studios. Okay, thank you so much for this song. Now, let us ask you about your inspiration in music. Do you see any idol? Do you have any idol or any inspiration?
Yeah, definitely. From the very childhood, actually, we idolize our father, our mother, our parents, actually. When we used to see them performing on stage, we were kind of sitting out there like audience in front of them. And we see that when they sing, when they perform, the way they interact with the audience, actually, the audience, the way they reacted to them, applauds them, actually. So those things actually always encourage us to feel like that, oh, in future, if we can do that, if we are performing, huge crowd is there in front of us, they will applaud for us. Though that sort of a feeling is always there in our mind.
And actually, I feel one of the biggest achievements for any artist is the applaud of the audience, the love of the audience,
that
the
is
respect
what we,
of the audience.
That is
it's
what
the
we
biggest
look for.
Gift you can have
as
artists, as creative people.
Definitely.
And you have also performed live shows. Of course, you have performed in live shows, and also you have recorded many songs in studios. So what difference do you find between a studio recording and interacting with a live audience? There are a large number of people.
Yes.
So what difference do you find, and which of the two do you like?
The difference lies in your expressions, the way you express the large audience, the large things, the large. And you ask me, what about the studio? Studio is a very compressed thing, as it is. And it's a different kind of experience.
We need to be very spontaneous, actually, while we perform in front of the audience. Because controlling crowd, interacting with them, getting their support, that's, you need an art, actually, to do that. It's
and
not that easy.
Preference change. When you sing in a recording, you must give your preference to the accuracy of your vocal tones, the pitching and all. So it comes little technical in the studios, but while performing live, it becomes more lively, and you must not think much about those accuracies, rather than giving focus to the audience.
Okay, so these are the basic differences that
We are not so expert to say that, actually. What we feel, what we
of
have.
Of course, from your own experience, and 15 years, of course, it's a long time. So I won't say that you, both of you, are not experts, but yes, you have a long way to go. And tell us about, you know, one of your biggest achievements was working in Ranbir Kapoor, Katrina Kaif star, and Chakka Jasus, where you have gave your rendered your vocals for the Bihu song. So how it happened, and how was the experience working with this film?
It became a part of our journey of music, actually. In our journey, we have met many good musicians like Anurag Saikia, Ishan Sharma, and many more who are now working in Bollywood. So Anurag is our very good friend, and he was the programmer of a few songs in Jagga Jasus. So Ishan Das also. So he approached us. The recording was done here in Guwahati. Yeah, he came here for some folk instruments, some folk group vocals, because most things are in Assamese language, and some Assamese instruments were used in the movie. So then he approached us, let's do it, Mandeep. And we just came, we were not prepared. We just went to the studio, we heard it for maybe 10-15 minutes, and we enjoyed it, actually.
It was a very popular song, and now that we are talking about this song, let's hear a few lines from that song, if possible.
Actually, the song, Galti Se Mistake, that part was not by us, but there was an SMS Bihu.
Yes.
That song, that part was sung by us.
So you can you just sing a few? Because Bihu is, you know, we love Bihu, and it doesn't matter at what time of the year we are listening to Bihu songs, so our audience will definitely love it.
Would like to sing another Bihu. That part,
sure,
Bihu was
Any
Bihu.
Any Bihu song.
Yeah,
any
yeah.
Bihu song, sure.
This Bihu was released by us.
Okay.
This is Phool Saneki. It's quite popular in YouTube and
sure,
all.
Sure.
Oh, tatote bohila phool saneki
হাতত লৈ উৰুকা গধূলি মোক বিহুৱান দিবলৈ তাততে বহিলা ফুল জানেকি হাতত লৈ উৰুকা গধূলি মোক বিহুৱান দিবলৈ তুমি তুমি যাবা আমি সূতা বিহুৱান মই বজাবে পেলেনো মোৰ কেঁচা কাম একো পপুলানি দিম একোপাতে গুজিবা একোপো ফুলানি দিম খোপাতে গুজিবা ও কিয় ধন সেনাই ঐ যতনাই রাখিছো বুক মরম তোমালৈ ও কিয় ধন সেনাই ঐ যতনাই রাখিছো বুক মরম তোমালৈ পাততে বহিলা ফুল জানে কি হাত লৈ উৰুকা গধূলি মোক বিহুৱান দিবলৈ আহিছো তোমাৰ কাষলৈ দুটি মনেতি হবলৈ কুলিতিয়ে মাতিলে তোমাৰ মনত পৰে তোমাকে নেদেখিলে বিহু বিহু নেলাগে ৰৈনো ৰৈ থাকিম বাটে চাই থাকি তোমাৰে ঐ মৰম পাবলৈ তাততে বহিছা ফুলজনে কি হাতত লৈ উৰুকা গধূলি মোক বিহুৱান দিবলৈ তুমি খুন্দি যাবা আশী সূতাৰ বিহুৱান মই ঢোল বজামে পেলাইনো মোৰ কেঁচা গাম
Wonderful, wonderful, and thank you so much for giving us this Bihu vibe inside our studio. Yeah. Thank you so much. It was a wonderful song. Now, Mandeep, you have also worked for a web series, Boygiri.
Boygiri.
So,
yeah.
What was your role in that?
I was the programmer, music
okay.
programmer.
Okay.
You can say music direction. Mm-hmm. There are some divisions in the music direction in Bollywood. Mm-hmm. Like there is a main music director, there are some sub music programmers. Mm-hmm. So I was a part of it. I did almost 5 episodes there.
Okay.
I was struggling in Mumbai, mm-hmm. and again Anurag gave me this offer, and for the Balaji Telefilms mm-hmm. I worked, mm-hmm. and it was a very good experience. And after that, my idea about the music production and the soundings, mm. it changed. Mm. Because after that, when I returned Assam for my works getting developed.
Yeah, because you know, my next question was about that only. I was about to ask you that you have worked in the national level, you have worked in Mumbai, you have also definitely worked here in the region, in northeastern region. And of course, you're also associated with an internationally acclaimed musical organization, Amrapali. Now, 3 different levels, regional, national, international. Now, you have experience of working in all 3 of them.
Yes.
Now, when you come back to Assam, what do you think that, of course, there is something, some improvement that needs to be done. So what are those and how we can improve the musical scenario in Northeast?
The basic difference is devotion and dedication.
Okay, okay.
People here are actually, people may think that the industry is not that big here. So let's compromise it with some extent and let's do it, okay, complete it somehow within the target time. But there in Bollywood or in the international levels, they never compromise with the quality and with their own works.
Okay, okay.
Somehow, if target is tomorrow, they will not eat, they won't sleep today, they will have to complete it, and they do that. So I just learned that from there, the dedication and devotion.
Dedication, so which is somehow you are saying that somehow lacking. Still lacking, but you know, we still have so much of talent in Northeast is full of talent. But it really saddens us to see that, you know, in spite of having so much of talent, we are still lacking behind. And something should really be done so that, you know, we can improve the scenario and we can focus our region in the national and international level. So
very recently, I need to add that there's a positive change. We can see the good musicians are coming out, good productions are now coming out from Assam also, and we can now compare this kind of musics. There are some sort of producers, we can compare them with the Bollywood level now.
Okay, so the standard is definitely improving. Which is a very good
sign. The new generation, they are coming up now. They are so skilled actually. Maybe you can attribute it to the internet. People actually, the musicians out here, they can see the people what they are doing around the world actually. That could be the maybe
they've got the exposure now. Earlier there was no exposure. Now when they compare themselves with the rest of the world, they see a lot
needs
to be
done. This is what's happening. So musicians, singers, all are so talented now. Okay, so they can compete actually now.
Of course we have the talent. What needs to be done is the dedication, and we have to like full-fledged go into that way. Now we have talked a lot, and now it's I think viewers are wanting to listen to another song from you. So any Hindi song this time?
Dilo o toda mi vida lo contaré, na me samjha, na me jana, jo bhi tumne mujhse kaha hai senorita, magar phir bhi na jaane kyun, mujhe sunke acha laga hai senorita. No debía la mirada, que era de cerca de mí, mucho bajo me tungero. Samajina, sarorita, chahat ke do pal bhi mil paaye. Duniya mein ye bhi gham hai kya, do pal ko do aao ko jaaye. Bhule hum ho to gham hai kya, sanorita, suno suno sanorita, kehte hain hum kya. Jo bhi pal bhi itni si to baat hai, no debí la mirada, que era de cerca de mí, mucho bajo me tungero, samjhi na, sarorita, chahat ke do pal bhi mil paaye, duniya mein ye bhi gham hai kya, do pal ko do aao.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for this song. Now, actually, we are running short of time. So I have quickly, I want to ask you this question, because we have also talked about your association with Amrapali, which is an internationally acclaimed organization. Tell us about a little about that.
It's basically about the creative arts, like live performance, creative performances, dance, some groomings, personality developments, and the music performances, classical. Mostly it's about Indian classical music. So we were associated with the Jayanta Bhagavati. He was the principal, kind of. So he himself and his wife, they were working in US. They had the institution. Recently they came to Guwahati after being so long. So now we have been performing in many stages in international platforms, even in India also.
Great, and wish you all the best for this.
Thank you.
And finally, we as an audience, as music lovers, we always crave for good music. So what can the audience expect from the M Brothers in the near future?
We are working in some good old melodies or some which are almost forgotten now, and so we want to again revive them with some good new musics.
Okay, so we can expect these songs to come this year.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, great. And Pooja is also approaching. So any Pooja songs that we can expect from you?
It's coming after in a schedule, not this time.
Working on that. Okay, thank you so much. We are actually running short of time. It was a lovely conversation with
thank
both
you.
Of you. And of course, our audience loved this episode because of this brilliant and beautiful musical environment that was created by the M brothers here, Mandeep Mohanto and Manmeet Mohanto, in our studios in Doordarshan Northeast. Well, viewers, it's now time that we have to wrap up this edition of Ek Mulaqat. Thank you so much for being with us. Have a great day ahead and be good.